before the girls arrive. I thought we'd be outside. We can watch the garden from here.
Good idea. Very nice view. Very nice view. Oh, Pix, what a journey. Your driveway is getting worse.
No doubt the girls will tell me about it as well. Nibbles?
Thanks. So, what does 70 feel like?
You'll find out soon enough.
Pix, where do the years go?
Travelling for you and family and kids for me. Cheers.
That's about to change. Cheers. Nice drop. Here's looking at uses.
You went to Casablanca, didn't you?
Yes, but that was a long ago in my gay hippie days. Nothing like where you're going. Now, what do the girls say?
Oh, this is perfect. Thank you so much.
It's to keep a record of your journey and your new life. Well, what did they say?
I'll write in it every day.
No, Pix, I know you didn't tell them, did you?
Sunday.
Sunday.
Now can I watch TV now?
Oh, ask your mother, darling. home in time to get your homework done.
Something wrong with Sunday?
Aren't we having some cake? Yes, let's have some cake.
Yes. Is something wrong with Sunday?
Well, I'm not sure yet.
Well, what are you doing or what might you be doing?
Well,
why don't you put your daughter first and accept my invitation to lunch on Sunday at the Mariners?
The Mariners? I remember going there with your father.
Oh, does that matter? It's just that Tom has a company expense account there, so we can go crazy, have whatever we want.
Oh, don't be so tactless, Lee. Why would Mum want to go anywhere that reminds her of Dad?
Surely that's all in the past.
Yes, but you don't forget that sort of thing, do you, Mum?
There's no point harping on about it.
He hurt your mother badly.
You think we don't know that? So, Mum, would you like to go to the Mariners on Sunday, where we can have a fantastic slap-up meal? Or somewhere else where Tom's going to have to watch the prices of absolutely everything you choose.
It's really unfair to put it like that.
Oh, it's all right, Abby. I agree with Lee, there's no sense in wasting money. The Mariners will be fine if that's what you and Tom have organised. It's probably changed a lot since then. Can I confirm later? When did you last see him?
Dad?
I don't know, I can't remember.
We saw Pop on my birthday.
Remember? Didn't we? Yes, I think you're right. It was Harry's birthday several weeks ago. And how is he?
Seemed okay, I suppose.
With his little piece with him?
Tina was with him. Yes, of course she was. What do you expect?
Well, since you asked, I expect her to fuck off when he's with family. That's what I expect.
Hey! Sorry. Well, I heard. She bought me a remote-controlled chug.
Oh, creep.
Oh, get over it, Lee.
It was nice of her, wasn't it, Harry?
Dad and Tina are an item, so build a bridge. Like it or not, she's going to be around our family.
Not part of my family, she is.
Oh, don't argue. It's my birthday. I really don't care about him or whatever her name is. She's welcome to him. He's a tool. Sorry, I didn't think. Shall we cut the cake?
Yeah.
Who's a tool?
No one, darling.
I'll get it. Do you want to help me?
Can I light it?
If you're careful. So, Mum, tell me the problem with Sunday. I can tell you're not keen. Is it because you used to go there with Dad?
No, not at all. This girl,
Tina.
Yes, how old is she?
Don't ask. She's using him, and he's too flattered to see and too old to care.
Oh, she'd be about 30.
Will it last?
Well, at least maybe for now, but you know Dad. I mean, do you care?
Do I care? I loved him once. He was my whole life and the father of my children, so it's hard to say I don't care. I'm not jealous,
but Mum, he cheated on you more than once. You need a new man. I mean, you don't want to be on your own for the rest of your life, do you? Actually, there's this guy at Tom's office. He's about your age, widow. Maybe if you come on Sunday, we could kind of make it like a foursome. I'm going to ask Tom.
A blind date? Oh, that takes me back. No, Lee, thank you. I don't think so.
Maybe it's Lee. Is Tom there?
Lee, I really don't want to do this.
Lee, your mother is saying she doesn't want
to.
Yes,
fine. Oh. Well, he didn't say he was going out today. No, he's not with me, Mandy, because I wouldn't call you if he was with me, would I? Well, no, Mandy, I don't actually know where he is. That's why I'm called. Just, okay, don't worry about it. I'll speak to him when he gets home.
Honestly.
Man. Okay, so we're all good for Sunday then?
Well, I just might have alternative plans, that's all.
Plans? What plans?
Oh, look, Lee, there's something I have to tell you both.
Oh, and about time, too.
Oh, this sounds serious. We better wait for Abby.
Yes.
Abby, hurry up!
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Nana. Happy birthday to you.
Abby, it's lovely. You cut it, please.
Tom, it's me. Not at work. Kind of just wonder where you are. wit's end.
Were you only joking?
What have you done?
Well, I've been online.
Online?
Oh my God,
I Googled partners.
You Googled?
Yes, and I found this interesting website.
Yes, Anne.
You put in all your particulars.
Oh, well, not everything, I hope.
No, of course not. And they show you all the possibles that might suit you.
Yes, we know that.
Do you?
Of course. So what happened? No, more to the point, what particulars did you give them? Name, age, bank account?
Oh, yes, all of that. Plus my daughter's, two daughters' names, addresses, bank accounts, and PIN numbers. Do you think I'm a complete fool?
So, who turned up?
Believe it or not, there are several gentlemen out there looking for the companionship of a 60-something-year-old.
Oh, 60-something? Is that what you told them? You didn't say 70.
I said 60-something.
So did you choose one of these guys? I mean, I'm just blown away by this.
Yes, I was attracted to one in particular.
Oh, my God!
Harry, have you got Fortnite on that?
Yes, why?
Shall we go in the house? I'm a whiz at Fortnite. Let's see if you can beat my score.
My Fortnite? Awesome!
Thank you, Toby.
Well, go on, tell us more about him.
He's single.
Single? How single? Widowed? Divorced? Any baggage? You know, kids, grandkids? I mean,
no,
what do you know?
No, nothing like that. Just single. And a doctor.
Medical doctor?
Where does he live?
Africa. West Africa.
Africa? Oh my God, Mom! Is he? Well, is he?
Is he an African? Black? What are you struggling with, Lee?
Don't be so difficult. Do you know what I mean? Is he really a doctor?
Yes, he's a witch doctor. And his name is Babanji. And he lives in a mud hut on the banks of the river. And he snacks on the smaller villages.
Stop it!
Well then, tell us, is he really a doctor?
Yes, he's a doctor. And he lives in Nigeria. But he's as quite an Australian as you or I. He comes from Melbourne, and his name is Charles Manson. Henson, Charles Henson.
I think they're both a bit shocked, to tell you the truth. Are you in constant contact with him? You know, chats, emails.
By phone, Abby. They do have phones in Nigeria.
By phone? So you've actually spoken with him?
Chatted most nights by phone.
Well, that's nice, isn't it, Lily? It's nice Mum's got someone to talk to when we're not here.
Does he actually work at the hospital?
Kind of.
Kind of what? Kind of work or kind of hospital?
Why so negatively are you wishing you had my freedom?
Oh, don't be ridiculous. I have my freedom
in my way.
Really?
Well, it's a university teaching hospital. Goes by the name of the Evangelist Hospital. It's Christian-based. In desperate need of treatment, who have no chance without people like Charles. This little boy, Winston, he trod on a nail. It went right through his foot, and he walked 25 miles to see Charles at the hospital with the nail still in his foot. And there are hundreds of other kids just like him.
Did this Charles tell you these stories? I'm sorry. I just think you're being scammed. Some old guy gets on the internet looking for some gullible divorcee, spins some story about his third world project, and then gives a sympathy line about children. Takes your money and runs into retirement. I mean, call me a cynic, but I have my concerns. For you, of course.
Oh, of course. This little kid, Winston.
What happened to him?
His foot was amputated. Oh. Too infected to save. 9 years old.
Oh, that'd be so sad if it was true. But where are the parents in these circumstances? That's what I'd like to know.
Oh, well, his father was out polishing the rolls, and his mother was having her nails done.
I think you should have mentioned this before now. I can't even imagine what Tom's going
to
say.
Oh, yes, Tom, with the company expense account. Charles would love to meet him. Is it necessary that he knows all my business?
Yes, he's just concerned about family issues that might affect our future.
Oh, is that your problem? You're worried that I might be giving away your inheritance to save little African children.
Don't be ridiculous, Mum. It's just that there's so many scams on the internet, in Nigeria in particular.
Just tell us honestly, Mum. Has he asked you for money for his hospital?
He didn't have to ask. No. I looked up the hospital online. You should do it yourself. Anyone would want to help.
They're a registered charity, and Charles is on the board of directors.
You're hopeless, Mum. You don't even know this man. I mean, how much have you given him? You should have asked us first.
Back off, Lee. Mum, have you given away much money?
Nothing.
Not yet. Well, that's good, isn't it, Lee? Now, tell us more about him. Everything you know. He sounds interesting.
I think he's more than interesting. Caring, kind, clever, and his work is making a difference in the world.
Well, as long as it's making him a big enough income that he doesn't come begging to you because you're making a fool of yourself, Mum.
Lee, where does this vicious streak come from?
Yes, calm down, Lee. You know nothing yet. Mum hasn't even met him.
Well,
I don't mean FaceTime. I mean face to face in the flesh.
So do I mean face to face in the flesh.
Mum! Are you serious?
Very serious. Do you think we seniors don't need a bit of flesh?
Oh, my God. It's disgusting. I don't want to hear anymore. You're chickening yourself, Mum.
Oh, mind your manners, Lee. You've no right to judge me.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm just concerned.
Oh, yes, so you said. You haven't been to see me for over 6 months, so I know how deep your concern is.
It's just where you live, and Tom working all these hours. Okay, so if you've met him, how long do we have to wait till we can meet him?
So you can check him out, you mean? Not much longer, he's outside.
Outside?
What do you mean? Where?
Outside, in my garden.
Oh my God, what's he doing outside?
He's up the ladder, painting the side of the house.
I believe it's the doctor man from Africa is outside in your garden now.
Yes, here, now, outside, in my garden. I'm surprised you didn't see him as you drove in.
Too busy getting attacked by that dog of yours.
What's he doing up the ladder, for Christ's sake? What if he falls? Insurance!
Oh, not if again, at Lee. What if he doesn't fall and he finishes painting the side of the house? Wouldn't that be a good thing?
Well, how long has he been here?
Well, up the ladder is about an hour.
You know what I mean. How long's he been here?
For the past week. He arrived last Sunday.
How?
By banana.
It's not going to be suitable for his ears.
Oh, leave him alone. Mum said it's all right.
Don't stupid. It's just a kid.
Well, there isn't going to be any conversation. I just thought you might be interested in our plans.
Look, as far as Lee and I see it, you met this young man on the internet. You know hardly anything about him, and now you want to go off to some unknown place in Africa and fund his hospital. Is that right?
I didn't say I was going to fund his hospital. His parents own a clinic in Lagos, hardly unknown, and Charles is the doctor. It's a registered charity run by volunteers and fundraisers. And I've offered to return with him to Africa to help administer the clinic.
As a volunteer?
Well, there will be a small salary, but he'll take care of me.
He'll take care of you?
Well, there is a bit more to tell you. You see, after we met, it seems there's some chemistry between us. And unlikely as it may seem to you, we've fallen in love.
Oh, no, you're old enough to be his mother.
You have such a nice way with words. I know I'm no Demi Moore, but such relationships can work.
Mum, you're not just getting back at Dad, are you?
No, I don't care what he does. Your father hurt me more than you would ever know. But Tina's just one in a long line of young girls throughout the whole of our married lives. So why is it okay for an old man to take up with a girl young enough to be his daughter, and he's doing all right for himself? But when the ages are the other way round, she's a fool or is being exploited.
You're right, of course, Mother. That's just the way it is. Give it time. Don't rush. There's still so much to think about. Do you even have a passport?
Yes, here. Brand new. Arrived this morning.
This is all wrong.
Nice picture, man.
Oh, lay off it, Harry. This has nothing to do with you. Your grandma's acting like an idiot.
How dare you?
Yeah, lay off, Lee. Look, this will probably just come to nothing.
Too late.
Why?
We're married.
Patricia Ann Henson.
Oh, for God's sake.
I don't expect good wishes or congratulations. But Charles is now a member of this family, and you have to accept that.
No, I won't accept any such thing. Mr. Henson, don't bother coming in, because you're not welcome. You can leave now.
No, Lee.
Yes, Abby.
No, Lee, you should go. If you find it so hard to accept that I have a life of my own.
But tonight, I'm married. I don't know what to say. I don't understand. Okay, I've got to go. Tom's working late and I'm
so angry at you.
Please, try to understand.
Goodbye, Mum, and good luck, because you're going to need it.
No, actually, one more thing. Did Uncle Toby know about this before us, your daughter?
Well, yes, I had to tell him. He's been very supportive. Oh,
sure he has.
Awesome!
go to the airport. Yes, they've all gone.
I'm ready. Quite ready.
But praise the Lord, you're back in civilization, safe and sound.
Cheese and pickle, Uncle Toby.
You mentioned ham.
I mentioned that there wasn't any. Mum?
No, dear, I'm really not hungry.
I am?
Yes, give it to Harry. He's a growing boy.
Mum, I'm really sorry about Charles. He was nice.
Yes, darling, I'm sorry too.
It's not fair.
No, life often isn't fair.
He's going to take me to the zoo.
Harry, honestly. We can always go to the zoo with Nana, can't we?
Come on, let's see the lions and tigers in Africa. And the white rhinos and
look, it's not impossible, dear. There's something I want to tell you all.
Really? Clay, come out here.
No, what now?
And me?
Yes, all of you. Toby, I'm only here for a couple of days to put my affairs in order, then I'm off again. I'm going back to Africa.
Oh, my dear girl.
No!
I'm not surprised. Who guessed?
No, you don't have to do that.
For God's sake, what about his house?
Ah, yes, your inheritance. I'm transferring the house over to both of you. You can do what you like with it. It's yours, your inheritance.
And what are you going to live on, thin air and bone?
They don't have food in Lagos. I shall be living on papaya, mangoes, bananas, all grown on our own plantation. Didn't I tell you, Charles was an extremely wealthy man. He owned properties all over the world, plus investments, so it all comes to me, so I'm very comfortable.
What about the clinic?
Well, his parents run the clinic. They always have. They're absolutely dedicated to the work. I shall stay on as administrator for a while at least, but I shall be living a life at Riley in the manor house. I have a plantation manager, 4 gardeners, 2 beautiful cars, 3 domestics, a pool, acres and acres of land. Oh, we have horses, Charles, love to ride. And a breathtaking view over the lake that shimmers in the morning sunrise.
Mum, the horses.
What happened?
With the accident. You were riding, weren't you? You and Charles.
No, indeed we were.
You've never ridden in your life.
No, but I always wanted to, though. And Charles was a great instructor, very patient. He put me on this steady old plodder, and we were walking along the banks of the River Oji. It was a hot, sultry day. The rainy season was ending, but we'd had a lot of heavy rain. And parts of the river had flooded over onto the pathway, so we had to be careful. After a while, Charles said that he'd go on ahead and check on the picnic lunch that the servants were laying out in the clearing. He told me to wait there by the river under the shade of this huge tulip tree. Looked magnificent as he galloped away from me towards the clearing. I loved him so much.
Yeah, what happened?
But after a while, the midges started biting and my horse was getting restless, so we started walking slowly along the riverbank towards the clearing where I could see Charles laying out the picnic blanket. But one of the servant girls was helping him, giving him a helping hand, if you see what I mean. I'd seen her helping him before at the clinic and at the house. She was young and he was a very attractive.
Bastard!
I couldn't bear to look, so I turned my horse around and he thought he was heading home and he bolted. I tried to hang on, but I couldn't. I fell off and rolled down into the river. I screamed, but Charles didn't hear me. Too busy. I got out of the water and I saw my hat was floating away on the ripples. I remember how pretty it looked. Then I heard Charles calling my name as he rode back from the clearing. I hid behind the tulip tree, and I didn't call back. He saw my floating hat and shouted out, but I didn't call back. He yelled out my name again, but I didn't call back. I stood very still and watched. I watched as he stripped off. And dived in to save me. I watched as the crocodile grabbed him, rolled him over and dragged him under. Then he was gone. Bubbles. Just bubbles.
Mum, whatever were you thinking? Why on earth didn't you call back to him?
Why? It was your father all over again. The younger woman. I won't be a fool for a second time.